Hi everyone and welcome back. So we are done with the restaurant controller and restaurant service, and in the last video we were writing the restaurant menu service, right? And I have created these DTOs, like we have restaurant menu param by ID, and for creating the restaurant we have the create restaurant menu param. What it contains? It contains some enum types that I'm not sure how it is going to look like on the Swagger, but let's give it a try. So for enum type is enum, meal type. Meal type will be the breakfast, lunch, dinner, and the cuisine type can be Italian, Indian, South Indian, North Indian, and the types, right? And we have a description of a menu, price, banner, media, all these things, okay? That we are doing in the restaurant controller. Let's do the pair programming and let's try to see how it is going to work, because I'm also not sure some of the hidden parts. Okay, and here we are on the restaurant menu controller, and here we are creating it. Okay, so menu service dot create, we are passing data, and we have, let's forget about update for now, we have the create, and we have get a particular menu for a particular restaurant ID, that is get menu by ID, let's call it, and this is get all menu, get all menu, or get menu by ID. The name should look correct. So we'll define it. So what we are passing here is a restaurant ID, right? So let's go to the menu service. So here, get all menu of a restaurant ID. So you can see menu wrapper dot find we can do, and where condition. So if you go to the menu, then here we have restaurant, right? That will be a foreign key in the menu. So you can just do a simple select star from menu where restaurant equal to the restaurant ID. That will give you all the menus for a particular restaurant. Okay, next thing we have is get menu by ID. Okay, so here we have two things. We have the ID, we have the restaurant ID. We'll just do the where condition with the two things. Get menu by ID. Okay, let's call it as a get menu by ID, and here we are again getting the params, and the params is of type restaurant menu param by ID. Are we writing it correctly? Okay, yes, and we have two IDs here, so we will get first is the ID, another is a menu ID. From this params, fine. So ID is this, and we have restaurant that is of type. Okay, ID should be of menu ID because we are looking into the menu table. Menu ID, and restaurant is the ID. So it's like a where condition where the primary key, like the menu ID is this, and the restaurant ID is this. Okay, get menu by ID. This is what we have. We can call this method. And this is going to return as the menu, not restaurant. It can be undefined also. It depends on what do we have. This dot restaurant dot find one. Let's see what it is saying. Restaurant undefined is not assignable to type menu. We have already converted it to, okay, restaurant repo it should be. Now we need to change these things. Here we are doing query on the menu. Here we are doing query on the menu repo. This is fine now. Okay, now we can focus on the create. Here we are creating menu for a particular restaurant, right? So what we will do is, first we will use restaurant repo and we will do find one. Okay, find one based on the ID. Can put a where condition where I'm looking for ID is here. We also have, let's do the create. What all we are getting in the controller, restaurant menu controller, and here it is our post. We are getting restaurant ID that we are getting in the params, so we have to pass both the things. Params is of type and the data is of type create restaurant menu. So we'll go inside the create. It is taking two arguments. Params is of type this and data is of type create restaurant param. Okay, fine. So we'll just do, we already have done the validations that the ID should must be there of type UUID. So here we are doing restaurant find. If restaurant is there, there may be a case where you are passing the invalid ID where it doesn't even represent a restaurant. Then if that is the, if we have restaurant as a null, right, what we can do is we can throw an error. Not found exception. Restaurant with ID not found. So here we can do params.id not found. Fine. So now we have restaurant and now we are creating menu. Right. So what we will do is we'll just follow the same steps. We'll create a const menu equal to this dot menu repo dot create. We'll create an empty object and then we will concat all the other properties there. Menu dot. I mean, either you do like this. Let me give a try to another way. And what we do is, this is my existing menu and all the other properties which I'm getting in the data. And what I can do is await this dot menu repo dot save, and I can just pass the payload. So let me just clean this out. And while creating the menu, right, we also need to define payload dot the restaurant, right? Restaurant we already have, which is restaurant dot find by ID. We have already received it. Oh, it is okay. This can be undefined. That is also correct. But we have already done the check. Restaurant undefined, then it will not even come there. We can put this in the else condition. It should fix this. Okay, we didn't do await. That's correct. Now we don't even need to do else part. Okay, we have assigned restaurant and we are now saving this in the menu. So we are actually, we got all the data from the DTO menu repo. We got the payload. We are just assigning the restaurant to the menu and then we are creating it. Right, very simple create operation, and it is going to return the menu repo. Okay, promise of menu, that is correct. We have to return this. And sometimes what you want is you want to handle the errors, right? So you can, here you can check if error instance of error of not internal server error exception throw error. So you will, you can handle these different kind of errors here if you want to throw explicitly, because here not found exception will be thrown here, and that you can see on the API response. Okay, we are done with the create, we are done with the get all menu, get menu by ID. So we get menu by ID and we are calling it from the controller. Just a typo. Why it is not saying get menu by ID? We are passing params of restaurant menu param by ID. Hey, menu service, what it is saying is, okay, private method, that's not good. It should be public only because controller is calling these methods. Private methods are those which are internal to this. And here, now we can do the, I mean, if you are deleting a menu, right? So this dot find by ID, so this dot menu repo dot find by ID. And here we are passing restaurant params by ID, which will contain both the things. Restaurant menu param by ID. So here we can get both the things, ID and menu ID. And we can do the basic check, okay, if this is ID is there or not. This common check is kind of everywhere. Even when creating this, we are validating, okay, is this representing a correct restaurant, the ID you are passing. We already have this ID. First of all, restaurant exists. Yes, restaurant exists. Now, we can just do menu report.find by ID, and we have this menu ID for this. Find by ID, because menu ID is not equal to ID, so we have to put the where condition where ID is menu ID. Why repository did you mean find by IDs? Okay, should not be a method. I think we have only find one. Find one, that should also be fine because there is a one, so it is a menu. If menu is there, then menu repo dot delete. But maybe we just want to check, okay, if what if you are passing invalid menu ID also, right? So that is the case only here, and we can pass. I think it also accepts the where condition. I think okay, in I think in the delete you can just pass the ID. It always treats it as a the ID which it wants to delete. Okay, criteria, string number, this is actually considered that as an ID. Otherwise, not found exception, invalid ID provided for menu, whatever the message, right? So this is delete, get by ID, get menu by ID, get all menu for a particular restaurant, create a menu for a restaurant. Some invalid import is there. Let's fix it by importing the correct entity. Here there is some error, find by ID. Okay, earlier we had one method. I think we can create one. This is for update. We are not running for update for now, so let's close it. Okay, now everything is clean. We can remove the unused imports, delete all unused declaration imports. And here is our restaurant service. So looks like we are done with the restaurant and restaurant menu. And this is our controller. Now what we will do is we will run this. We will see everything in the Swagger pack. Few things which we need to just clean about the API descriptions. What is required in the DTOs, because we didn't put a description. Most of the time this is required true, right? So we need to map it with the entity. Whatever is not nullable in the entity should not be required false. That should be required true. And the proper validation should also be done here. Like, okay, for the menu, the name is required true, id string, okay, means that should be done. We can also add another validation like minimum length is greater than 2, length is 2, that should be the name of menu, right? And let's say type is also required, minimum length 2. Similarly, meal type, these all are required, and this is of type 2, required true meal type, this is also required. All these things will reflect in your API spec using this API property Swagger annotation. Media is kind of, you can say, optional, because it's not necessary. Everybody is going to add a banner or something for that. So required false. So what we will do is we'll add is optional here. Okay, banner is again required false, and let's add of is optional. API property price, yes, this is not optional, this is required true, this is optional. Okay, that's it. Let's connect in the next video. Meanwhile, I will just deploy it on Docker, and let's see our API spec. Okay, thanks everyone.